And in PhD program, we moved on to, again, taking a very challenging program of tissue culture, mass multiplication of grapes with Dr. Pandey, who was again a visionary, who moved on to become director of Indian Institute of Horticulture Research later. And then this I'm telling for the youngsters that they should know. And after that, he went for a postdoctoral fellowship in Japan. Again, worked on very challenging problem. And coming back, we again had time together in Tata Energy Research Institute. Then now it is called the Energy and Resources Institute. So in Terry, again, he worked with the tissue culture pulp plant and pioneered many very important programs before on. He moved on to Indian Institute of Vegetable Research as senior scientist in biotechnology. And then he came to IRI and provided a strong leadership as head division of horticulture. When I say strong in the sense that, you know, we had two mango varieties, Amrapali and Mallika. And when we were a student in BSc Agriculture in Banaras University, we used to read about both Amrapali and Mallika. They were developed around 1972-73. And it was until, you know, 2008-2009 that there was hardly any coverage under these two varieties. But today we can proudly say the kind of initiative he took in terms of popularizing these varieties. Now you can see whole of Jharkhand, Odisha, Andhra, Telangana, and Karnataka, that these two varieties have made a big dent. And then he provided a very strong leadership to a mango breeding program, and number of varieties like Surya, Pratibha, Lalima, these varieties came up. And I keep always discussing with Dr. Sanjay that we have to work with the same vigor and enthusiasm how we can take forward these varieties to the scale of, you know, Amrapali, Mallika, because these varieties obviously have much better color and taste, sugar content is less, and they meet the international demand. And the only limitation that we have is how to have large multiplication. That is a big challenge. And that's where, you know, I was discussing about some of the Israelis' technologies that they are doing in Basti, about 1 lakh plant multiplication of mangoes. We can join hand with some such people and see how we can proceed further. And after that, he took the leadership of NHB, National Horticulture Board, and also the Coconut Board. So again, you can see the kind of diversity that he has in terms of providing the leadership to the vast range of areas before he became Deputy Director General of Horticulture. And for last 2 years, till recently, he was also looking after the Deputy Director General Crop Sciences, and a large number of varieties during the last 2 years period. I think this was one time when most of these CBRC meetings were held very, very regularly, very, very regularly. And more than 400 varieties during this last 2 years period have been released for commercial cultivation. So I'm really thankful to him for kindly agreeing to be here with us to provide guidance to all these youngsters who are here, who have received this training program at IRI, and also encourage and challenge the faculty members to do what best we can do in IRI to excel further. So once again, I would like to thank him for his gracious presence, and thank you all for being here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I kindly request Dr. C. Vishwanathan, Coordinator, School of Basic Sciences, IRI, and PI, NHB CAST, to give his remarks.
Honorable Deputy Director General, Horticulture Crops, Dr. Anand K. Singh, respected Dr. Ashok K. Singh, Director, IRI, Dr. Rashmi Agarwal, Dean, Dr. K. M. Manjaya, Associate Dean, and Dr. Sindhu, Head Floriculture and also Coordinator School of Horticulture Crops, Dr. Tomar, Head Vegetable Sciences, Dr. S. K. Singh, Head Fruit Sciences, Dr. Kumar, and our training director, Dr. T. K. Begara, and course coordinators Dr. Amit and Dr. Gogra Singh, and all the faculties from School of Horticulture and other discipline, and dear student participants. It is a great opportunity for me to speak a few words about the project that we are running at IRI before our Deputy Director General Horticulture and Crops. Sir, this project was given to IRI in the theme area of genomics assisted crop improvement and management. We have chosen this broad topic for this program because in this, under this program, we cover more than 15 disciplines of IRI. Otherwise, if we choose any narrow topic, then we will not be able to cater to the needs of other people. And also, it is genomics is emerging as an important tool. So if we can harness the benefit, then it will be very useful for sustainable agriculture. That's why we have chosen a tagline of shaping human resources to harness the global gene pool for sustainable agriculture for our this program. Sir, this program is under cost of NAHEP, wherein the PG education is given important. So we have, keeping in that mind, we have mainly focused on student research. Many of the cost program, they focused on research by using only few RESRF. In this program, we thought we will get all our research work done from the students only. So for enhancing the skills of the students, we offer 10 to 15 days training program. So in this, we select IRI student as well as student from different universities, sir. So far, this is the 10th training program, and which is coming to the valedictory today. So we have trained about 300 students from more than 70 universities and covered almost 25 different states. And then in addition to this 10 to 15 days training, for IRI student, we go further. We selected about 22 students for training abroad for 3 months, sir. So some of the students, they have gone, only few students, they will be going before March for 3 months training and the well-established labs abroad. So once the students are trained, it is also important to see that these students, they use the skills in their research work. So for, since genomics is money intensive research, we are also giving research grant to an extent of, like, it varies from 1 lakh to 15 lakh depending upon the research problem and its relevance to the objective of the project. So almost we have given a research grant to 89 students. We have about 12 core team members under the leadership of our director. We select the student and then we have given the research grant for all the students for doing their research, genomic research, so that they, when they use it in their research program, they remember for longer time. And we also give small funds to attending conferences, like if somebody wants to go abroad to attend a conference or if they attend within the country. So that is also given so that students go and interact with the other faculties and students. Then they learn to project their research work. So the next component is the faculty. Although the faculty training is not a big objective in this program, we still have about 80 lakhs of money for faculty training. So far, 9 faculties have been selected for training abroad, 3 months duration each. So next year also we will have slot for another 10 faculty. So in addition to this facility establishment, we also establish on common facilities. Sir, I think by March it should be ready. So about 6 crore worth of equipments, they will be housed in a common facility so that students from different disciplines, they can come and use the equipment without any restriction. And all the training program we organize, sir, we have webcasted all the lectures so that the students from other universities, they can read and they can get benefit. So this is in brief about the program. Thank you, sir. We thank you very much for coming to this program. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. I now invite Dr. T.K. Behra, Professor and Course Director, to kindly present the training report.
Honorable Deputy Director General Horticulture, Dr. A.K. Singh, sir. Director this institute, Dr. Asu Kumar Singh, sir. Then the Dean and Joint Director of Education, Dr. Asmi Agarwal. And PI of the project, Dr. C. Viswanathan. Then nodal officer of this project, Dr. Manjaya, head of the divisions in the vegetable science, Dr. Thumar, Dr. Sindhu from floriculture, head of the divisions, and Dr. S.K. Singh from fruit and horticulture technology, scientists, dear participants, students. So it's really a proud privilege for us because we are from the faculties of the discipline of horticulture, and we have our own deputy director general, Dr. A.K. Singh sir, here. So definitely it is a great prestige and honor for us that we are here and also have this type of interactions with you, sir. As I mentioned, sir, taking to the horticulture as a whole, this time also in the NHEB program, there are 15 students of the horticulture. They got this genomic facilities at IRI, and they are doing also research in the genomic research, particularly in the different crops and fruits and horticulture, as vegetables, as well in the floriculture crops. Similarly, just extending the students' activities to the abroad, we have also selected 3 students to be in horticulture section to go to have a training in abroad. And also scientists also selected for this particular program to go for this 3 months training program in the University of in the US. Coming to this students and participants, we have about 90 students have applied, sir, for this particular course, particular genomics in horticulture crops. And we selected based on their performance. Also, the different criteria were selected here because the students, they have already got, those are being SRF and GRF in their program, UG program. And they migrated from one university to another university for their UG, then PG, then PhD. So they even students are there having 3 different universities they are traveling. So in that criteria, we have selected many students. Another criteria is that their program should be on the plant breeding and genetics or any related to the work on the molecular biology. So that way we have selected. So 27 students selected. And that is from different states, about 14 states, starting from Kerala, then Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Punjab, UP, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Delhi, Arunachal Pradesh. So all 14 states we have the students. There are 27 students, including we and IRA here. Another important thing is that the students also from 16 universities. So that is also we have taken the care of all the people should be accommodated. At least we have a representative for all peoples. And really they are the ambassador for the horticulture sector is concerned if it is there. I think in this particular program, we have a lectures series from different organizations including NIPGR, NBBGR, we have NIPB. Also, the resources, human resources already available in our genetics divisions, which is totally vast and parallel to any of these organizations here in India. So including many students, many faculty members are also IRA alumni, and they're very good lectures. And it is, if you consider the lectures itself, and they have, starting from this, even we go for this and gel analysis in the by electroporosis. Also, we have a tilling and eco-tilling in the different crop plants, transcriptomics for the applications in the horticulture crops. Also, we have the speaker like Dr. N.K. Singh sir, and also we have Dr. Bharadwaj and Dr. C. Viswanathan in the last day today. He has having no time, but still he has taken the class today and before because the students also requested him long time. And we have a practical, also very good practical, including the software analysis for GWAS analysis, also QT analysis, mapping of different tests, how they go for mapping. So we have taken all the best teachers to have the analyze this particular aspect of different mapping and other factors or gene association mapping, everything. And all we included here. So even if we have started with the next generation sequencing, how it is important for our horticulture crops. Also next generation phenotyping, which is done by Dr. C.I. Viswanathan. So these things we have taken, and even the bioinformatics, we have taken the guide from this ISRI, and people, they will go for bio, like A.R. Rao and other people also involved in this program. So we have a long list of the resource persons who has given a long experience in this particular field, and the students are really exposed in this particular way. So I think now we can also have some other programs like also that we have seen the performance of the students during the program. If you see that evaluations, we did it in the beginning of this project, in this this training. And the lowest mark at that time was only 12. And highest was having 20, I was highest out of 40 marks. But here, just glad to say that out of 40, they have secured 36 marks, the highest mark, and 28, which was the highest in that time, it was now lowest here. So I think they have some, at least, understanding of the subject, what they actually do it.
And yeah,
it's the same standard. We took the same standard. No, sorry, sir. No, same question. The standards are same, but questions are, but actually they are benefited out of that. And also we have taken the feedback from them, sir. That is for the resource person, which class is good and which one is the worst or something like that. That is not the worst, but what is good. So that way they have taken their marks also from them, 90% or 100% or how much they are satisfied with this class. So that also we have taken, so it will not tell here now, but it is there with us only. At least we can have improvement, sir.
You can tell.
No, sir, we can have some improvement in this year. So just have an introduction of the students, to our participants. Only if you permit, sir, then we can have at least one
brief,
or two students, brief student, name and their work and also their university. That's all. Please, introduce yourself one by one.
You can tell. What have you learned, very briefly?
Yeah.
That's also a test how sir, brief you can be.
We'll have a feedback also, two people will come and then we'll do. But only you can, sir, if possible. Please, go. It will be done. Yeah.
Myself, Rimon Shah Chaudhary from Uttarbhanga Krishi Vishwavidyalaya. I am pursuing my PhD on third year. And my work is on genetic variability and morphological and biochemical studies of small size potato tuber with virus P planting material production through in vitro propagation.
So myself, Reva Naik, I'm third year PhD student from Division of Foods and Horticulture Technology, IRI. I am working on in vitro mutagenesis and validation of mutant CC molecular models in kino membrane.
Sir, my name is Rajni Rajin. I'm pursuing my PhD from DAU Sabah. Recently, I'm working on in vitro mutagenesis
for the improvement against salary. Good evening, sir. My name is Megha Raghavan. I'm from Central Agricultural University, Imphal. My work is on evaluation of genetic diversity of mandarin using morphology and
myself Deepak Mora from Bihar Agricultural University, Sabar, Bhagatpur, Division of Vegetable Science, second year PhD student. My research problem is breeding tomatoes for cultivated disease resistance. Thank you, sir.
My name is Kota Tamil. I'm from Arunachal Pradesh. I'm doing MSc second year in Central Agricultural University in Imphal. And my work is genetic variability of leaky mustard. This is basically a genetic of no science step.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself Nomi Singh from PND Chip Morgan Ayodhya. My work in PhD problem is genetic variability and correlation in Azrael.
Agriculture Institute Ranchi, Jharkhand, and my work on the diversity mapping of jackfruit for nutritional values and food in Jharkhand.
Good evening, sir. I'm Krishna Jayar Nayak from University of Horticulture Science, Bagalpur. I'm pursuing my third year PhD in genetics and plant breeding. I'm working on the drumstick with aspects of morphological and molecular characterization, nutritional profiling, and standardizing tissue culture protocols.
Good evening, sir. I am Vipin, second year PhD student in the division of Floriculture and Landscape Architecture, IARA. I am working on managed stress genotyping and transcriptome analysis in drought tolerance of chrysanthemum.
Good evening, sir. Myself Srikant from Dr. YSR Horticulture University, Andhra Pradesh. I am pursuing PhD in the Department of Vegetable Science. My research problem is genetic analysis and validation of markers linked to powdery mildew resistance and other traits in chili.
So, okay. Thank you, sir. And now continue with another program, sir.
Thank you all. I kindly request ma'am, Dr. Rashmi Agrawal, Dean and Joint Director, Education, IARI, to give her remarks.
Thank you, honorable chief guest of this valedictory function, Dr. Anand Kumar Singh, DDG Horticulture Sciences, ICR, our honorable director, Dr. Ashok Kumar Singh, the director of this particular course, Dr. T.K. Behra, our PI of the project, Dr. Vishwanathan, IC heads of the division, Dr. Tomar, Dr. Singh, and Dr. Sindhu, and core members, faculty members of Horticulture Sciences, and dear students or trainee students. So this is a great opportunity that students have got this to be trained under this project, NHEP CAS project, which is on the training program is on the genomics for the improvement of horticulture crops. Friends, all of you are aware that horticulture crops are very, very important in food security and nutritional security, more say. And with the recent genomics tool available, lot of things can be done with these improved tools. And I was just going through the program. There are a large number of lectures and practicals, which Dr. Behra also very well said that these all have been, all the trainees have been given hands-on training also for many of the practicals. Specifically, I see among the students also, most of them are working on the biotic stresses. Their main objective is the improvement of vegetables or horticultural crops. For the biotic stresses, mainly I see a lot of fungal problems, Staphylium, Phomopsis, and Fusarium is also one of the notorious pathogen which is affecting large number of vegetable crops, and also Staphylium and viral diseases. So it's a very good platform that all the trainees have received, this training program, all the students. As said by Dr. Vishwanathan and also Dr. Behra, this particular program, CAST program, is student oriented. Most of the students are given training under this program, and roughly by now we have conducted more than 15 training programs, and I see there are 25 trainees from 16 different universities who are getting trained in their very early research career. So to say, you are PhD programs. Most of the students are in their PhD second or third year, and very few are MSc students. So friends, if you are at this stage, are being trained in this recent tools and techniques, specifically the genomics tools, wherein you can identify markers, you can utilize these based on the next generation sequencing and other things. You can develop your pre-breeding programs, you can identify QTLs, you can do association mapping, and also you can identify the markers linked to the biotic and abiotic stresses. So this is a very, I must say, the great opportunity you have received by becoming a part of IRI, and after this training program, I'm sure your programs, which you are already having for your PhD, they will be strengthened, and it will help in your PhD research programs, and also it will give you an opportunity to, when you go back to respective universities, you can even share your experiences, and you can give a small 15 or 20 minute seminar also on the topics which you have learned here, where you have developed some more confident than you were before this training program. So I once again, with these words, congratulate, and I'm so grateful that today we have our DDG Horticulture Sciences with us, and he will be giving his views from ICR point of view also, and where we should take our research in the horticulture sector per se. So with these words, I thank the organizers for inviting me on this occasion, and all the best wishes for you in your future endeavors. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. I now request the student participants to give their feedback about the training program. Students.
Respected dignitaries on the dais, Dr. A.K. Singh sir, Director IRA, and Dr. A.K. Singh sir, DDG Horticulture, and Project Investigator NAHP, Dr. Vishwanathan sir, and our Joint Director Education and Dean, Madam Rakshi Agarwal Madam, and our Course Director Behra sir. Good evening and welcome to all present here. Myself, Anavina, from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University. First of all, I would like to say thanks to the NAHP CAST team for organizing this valuable training program regarding horticulture genomics in the Division of Vegetable Science. And my special thanks to Dr. Vishwanathan sir, and my co-director Behra sir, and coordinators Gograt sir and Amit Goswami sir for giving me a wonderful opportunity to learn from IRA. Regarding the course, this 10 days gave us, on behalf of all the students, I am saying that in the 10 days we have learned many advanced technologies in the genomics. That was really interesting and new to us. And also the faculties, they put extra efforts to teach us, and they also very much involved in teaching us from fundamental to the advanced level. And they also teach us how genomics works on breeding program, and also explain their application in the crop improvement program, and discussions were going on in a good manner, which was enjoyed by all the students in the class. And also the exposure visits like NIPB department, the next generation sequencing, and genomics assisted breeding theory classes, and a practical exposure on pre-breeding techniques, and speed breeding, and transcriptomics expression related studies, and I feel very happy to learn from the Department of Floriculture that marker assisted breeding and practical exposures in a tissue culture lab, which which our tissue culture ma'am put an extra efforts to teach us, and also the DNA and RNA extraction technologies protocols also were taught in a nice manner, and we feel very excited to visit that phenomics facility and phytotron facility and NPP chair visit, and bioinformatics land was quite useful and needy thing for the current research scholars, and software teaching were done in a perfect manner in their respective departments. It was amazed to see that supercomputer Ashoka for the first time in the statistics bioinformatics department. Apart from this, regarding accommodation and food, our coordinator and director really arranged in a nice manner, and we enjoyed a lot. And we had a good experience with my colleagues from different states. Our country not only having diversification in the cultures or languages, but also in crops, so that we people can feel proud of this for this uniqueness. We should work on it. Totally, this training program was a very very beautiful experience and valuable experience, which improved my genomics knowledge. And also, I feel very delighted to be a part of it. And thank you one and all present here, and thank you for the opportunity. Next to it.
A very good evening to all the dignitaries present on the dais and off the dais, all the scientists, teachers, and my dear friends. Myself, Anamika Upadhyay, and I'm from Department of Vegetable Science, Bidhan Chandra Krishi Vishwavidyalaya. So first of all, I would like to thank for giving me this opportunity to share my views in front of you all. So we all know giving a better understanding, getting a better understanding about omics is very much essential for researchers nowadays. So learning model biotechnological approaches and orientation towards the molecular practices was very much interesting and resourceful. It was my great pleasure to mention that these 10 days training program had greatly enriched the understanding and knowledge towards various new techniques like applied these days, starting from various, as my colleague said, next generation sequencing, QTL mapping, association mapping, bioinformatics, about high throughput phenotyping, including the phenomics and phytotron techniques. We have various practical sessions was also there, various field visits. The various teachers are giving their best to cover almost all the topics in this limited period of time. Thank you for all their efforts towards us. It was really amazing to visit some of the well-established facilitated labs present in IRI. It was our privilege to visit over here, and a dream come true, obviously. I would like to thank all the teachers and the course coordinators and course director to give us this opportunity to come over here and from a diverse place and come over here, share our experiences. Also, we got to know about various topics which we are working on, and got to know not only in our own topic, we got to know about the different topics which people are working over, and what and all extra things which are going over all over India or all over the universities, where people are doing various works on various aspects. So thank you for giving us this opportunity. I would like once again I would like to thank everyone in front I would like to thank everyone on behalf of all my friends. Thank you.
Thank you all. I now invite the dignitaries on the dais for the distribution of certificates to the participants.
Okay.
I invite the first participant, Riman Shah Chaudhary from Uttar Banga Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, West Bengal. Next is Thevanai M. IRI. Next is Rajni Rajan from Bihar Agricultural University, Sabur, Bhagalpur. Next is Megha Raghavan from Central Agricultural University, Imphal. Next is Ravi Pratap Singh from Acharya Narendra Dev University of Agriculture and Technology, Kumarganj, Ayodhya. Ravi Pratap Singh. Next is Bhanusri. Sahana. Ipsita. Vithya. Purushottaman. Purushottaman. He's from Tamil Nadu Agriculture University, Coimbatore. Mujib Ahmed from Sardar Vallabhai Patel University of Agriculture and Technology, Meerut. Mujib Ahmed. Anamika Upadhyay from Bidhan Chandra Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, Nadia, West Bengal. Anamika Upadhyay. Athulya MP, Kerala Agriculture University, Thrissur, Kerala. Panchal Bhattacharyaji, Anand Agriculture University, Anand. दीपक मौर्या, बिहार एग्रीकल्चरल यूनिवर्सिटी, साबोर, भागलपुर. Toto Tamut from Central Agriculture University, Imphal. Manisha Rani from Punjab Agricultural University, Ludhiana. Neha Verma from Punjab Agriculture University, Ludhiana. Navneet Singh from ANDUAT, Kumarganj, Ayodhya. Naveena N, TNAU, Coimbatore. Suresh Chandra Gurjar, Birsa Agriculture University, Ranchi. Suresh Chandra Gurjar. Dudukuri Srikant from Dr. YSR Horticultural University, Andhra Pradesh. Bibin from IARI, Division of Floriculture. Reena Prosti, Division of Fruits and Horticultural Technology, IARI. C.S. Prashant, Sher-e-Kashmir University of Agriculture Science and Technology, Kashmir. Krishnaja R. Nair, University of Agricultural Sciences, Bagalkot. Now it's time for the course coordinators to receive the certificate.
Dr. Gogra Singh Jat, the course coordinator, so clap for them because they are the real player in the winning in the background. They are doing work, a lot of things. Yeah, so there's a huge applause. Eh? Okay, now Amit Kumar Goswami, also another coordinator of this program. And because of them, I think a lot of work has been done by smoothly for these divisions, and we work together to work for this one. So thank you both of them. I really, it's wonderful for you. Yeah. Okay, sir. Please.
There's nothing for you?
No.
Thank you, sir.
I now invite Dr. Anand Kumar Singh, Honorable DDG Horticultural Sciences, to address the gathering.
sir, fixed. Sir. Okay. 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 No problem.
Thank you. Thank you so much, and almost good evening to everyone. When this program, which is part of the Ministry of Agriculture and also the Ministry of Education, to enhance the skill of the future generations, is being conducted here, was conducted here, particularly this program. And I was watchful when he was reading the names of the universities these students have been drawn for this particular training. It was really good to know that they are drawn from 15 or 17, 16 different universities located in different parts of the country. That's really good one, actually. They represent many regions of the country and many universities in real spirit. And this is being held at IRI. That's really a great ecology. When I'm here, then before I go ahead, I must mention here that we have one institute called as Indian Institute of Spices, located in southern India, southern tip almost. They have developed a protocol for the black pepper, where they have examined the various ecology of the black pepper in different agroclimatic conditions. And they have characterized the microbes in the root zone. And based on that, they have found after 3 years of experiment that this microbes consortia of, if it is added into different regions also, it increases the growth, there is improvement in the flavor, there is improvement in the quality. As a result, yield and production is much higher. So this kind of training, when it is being organized here in IARI, which is a great ecology of education, great seat of education, training, expertise, generation of ideas, which has driven Indian agriculture for the level where we are saying that we are producing this much of grains, this much of fruits, vegetables, ornamentals, and many, many, many more feats that institution has been awarded and recognized for. So it's always great to come here once again to this ecology, and many faces, those who represent the faculty here, they are here, and it's can't be better than this, that we have Ashok Kumar Singh as the director of this institution. We have been classmates for so many years, and when we used to finish our classes in BHU, then we would come together, walk. We didn't have the bicycle. Between hostel and his house, our hostel and his house was very close. But between the college and, the faculty and the hostel, his home, there used to be a temple, Varanasi temple, Shankar Bhagawan ka mandir hai wahan pe. So we'll come together. I don't think any occasion when we would have come separately. I don't know. I don't remember, at least. Such was the routine, and the talk of these two people, one very tall and one very dwarf, used to catch the attention of everyone. Everyone. One is so tall, the other one is so dwarf. How come these two can gel? One from such a height and the other one, if they are talking together, he must be bending so many times to talk to him. But then we'll come, and maybe sometimes we'll sit in our room also, then he will go, and especially he will be remembered when there is exam. If some student has any doubt, then it will be cleared by him. I take pride that I have a friendship with him, and I take pride that he is leading such outstanding, I would say this is the Harvard or Stanford or Kellogg or California of agriculture in India. You are giving a great leadership today. And if any friends has any problem,
And if he is not visible, although, I mean, he will be visible because he was so hefty then also. Then the GI will be that he will be in A.K. Singh's room. He will be in my room. So I must be having some problem. That is why he is not visible outside. So first of all, he will clear my doubts. Then the chances will go to somebody else. So we had this kind of friendship. And when I'm taking pride in this, then I want to communicate the same thing to you also. Two things, actually. And on this occasion, this is the first occasion, I think, as a director, which we both are sitting here on this program. And with us, we have the dean of this university, Rashmi, and Vishwanath, a very good friend of mine, an outstanding scientist like A.K. Singh. Behra, the course director, and Dr. Singh, head of fruits and horticulture. Dr. Saab baithe hain bagal mein, floriculture ko disha de rahe hain. Dr. Saab vegetables ko de rahe hain. Dr. Sindhu and Dr. Bhopal Singh. Many people I mean, are sitting here, there in the back also. I have worked, or I have a professional relationship with them. And it's such a good occasion that we are here. On a valedictory function of this particular World Bank funded program, where the idea is to hone the skill of people, those who are going to be the future workers for our university's ICR system, and attend the problems of horticulture sector particularly. Yesterday we had a meeting where Dr. Singh was also there, and where DGE was chairing the meeting, where that was a very big group actually, many big so many experts from the various disciplines were called for how much funding is to be given for a particular area, the strategic funding for basic researches. So this was one of the areas everybody was unanimous that this area should be given preference. And this is how we can say that the Government of India plans ICR particularly, that this area has a great potential to address the needs of the country. And the DG was also asking that, what are the different areas from every DDG, he was asking, give us a few ideas. What are the areas from your discipline which should be given funding in this particular strategic fund allocations? Then I was saying that since we are producing so much and Prime Minister is giving us many mandates, many targets in fact, that in the next 2.5 years or 3 years, by the turn of 2022, we have to double the income of the farmers. And we have to convert our $2.6 trillion economy to a $5 trillion economy. And we have to double the exports from $36.6 billion to $70 billion or $75 billion. Or Niti Aayog says that it should be $100 billion. So when these things are there in the talk, then we have to find our fitness in terms of the product, the conditions that we have. We have a huge Himalayan range. We have huge subtropical locations, massive area in subtropical zones. And on the top of everything else, there is a big demand of the tropical and subtropical fruits and vegetables in exotic conditions, exotic countries. And lot of expatriates, population of Indians, I mean, expats in America is so much. I think 30 lakh, 3 million or 3.5 million people, those who live in America. They have their palate. They are looking for the palate which they have been raised and grown in India. They might have shifted to United States or Europe or any other continents, but they still have the same palate. They want the products which they tasted, they eaten, they grew in, the flavor, the taste, and the conditions in which it is grown. That is India. So there's a huge market for us. But the thing again is that on many occasions we find that, for example, yesterday also I cited, Dr. Singh was there, I think he will remember, that we are exporting huge amount of the black pepper as such, which is used as a spices. And a portion of this one is also used in the condiments. But I said to DG that let us have a project on how we can identify, of course, the institution has identified, characterized, and quantified the bioactive compounds in Kali Mirch. And let us identify the complete protocol for isolation, do the crystallization, pack it well, and then explore the market. We have conducted the studies that there is a huge market in Europe and North America. Maybe other continents also, we may not be knowing. But I think this is where the demand is there. This is where the opportunities are there. However, we need this trained and skilled people. We need the technology available. And these technologies has to be shared with those people, those who have the capability to invest in, because the horticulture is an area which is capital intensive, knowledge intensive, technology intensive. At the same time, this also suffers from these set of crops, they are termed as a high value crops, but the perishability is very short. And the vagaries of the nature affects these set of crops much more than cereals, I think. So we have to be prepared, we have to develop our preparedness, and this starts from the universities, the seat of educations, like you represent, we stand here, which has brought us here. And once you have chosen yourself, I mean, agriculture or vegetable science or any discipline of agriculture, then you have your inspiration. You want to build your career and build your career successfully. And this is only your training and skill periodically improved version of it. Unless you adopt, unless this is given to you, you will not gain the confidence. You will not gain the confidence. You might face difficulty also to achieve your goals you might have set for yourselves. So this is the very beginning when you are in the process of attaining your PhD degree. And as a part of the PhD programs, you have got a chance. I must congratulate you that out of so many 1:3 ratio success rate, so you have replaced 3 candidates to get a seat here. And I have traveled across the world. I might have visited more than 36 countries, which I have listed. And the teachers of IRI are fantastic. And teachers like A.K. Singh, I didn't find anywhere. I tell you, it's not because he's my friend. We have grown together. It's not because of that. It's a fact. We still remember. We had, on many occasions, on many issues, divergent opinions. But still we'll sit together. He will say his points, I will say my points. But nevertheless, he will always maintain a very calm and very quiet temper to deal with. And I don't know how many classes he has taken, but it will be great if you increase the number of his classes in any of the training programs in future which you are going to conduct. And when it comes to talk to the rice, particularly the basmati, the flavor of basmati, wherever it goes, A.K. Singh goes there. So he is such a fantastic teacher. Sometimes I envy also. He was tall and I was dwarf. He is so good, I'm not so good. this is very telling actually. There are a lot of things to learn out of these relationships. And luckily you are here and you have the shared commitment he might have expressed during his talk with you for Indian agriculture. So the challenges for horticulture is really enormous. Potential is much more than we might have fathomed. It's much higher. Whatever we have achieved in terms of quantum of production, it has not happened just as a happenstance. No. It has happened because of the inputs, alignment of the government policy, innovative technologies development by the institutions, IRI or similar institutions. And more than that, I would say that the staff of this great institution connecting themselves with the farmers or stakeholders with great robustness to communicate the theme of the technology so that they can adopt with great ease and get the potential benefit out of this one. Now, if I tell you that, I mean, we are producing, you know it, but I'll mention that, let us say, we are producing 53 million tons of potato against the requirement of 40, 41, sometimes it is 39 or even less than that. And you'll be surprised to know that in India, we have the largest amount of the cold storage capacity. December 31st, 19, 36.7 million metric tons. Still, losses is more than 25%. So what to do if the cost of production of potato is, it ranges in different agro-climatic conditions, 4 to 6 rupees or 6.5 rupees, half rupees or 7 rupees also. Then if the even if the average requirement of the country for potato is, let us say, 40 million tons, and the availability is 53. So 13 million tons is excess. And into 6 rupees per kg. How much money is wasted? What to do with that? And when I'm saying this, not for the sake of communicating the statistics, what I'm trying to say here is that we don't have a large number of varieties which have the processable traits. We always focused on either yield or disease or pest resistance. We did not deploy our resources to develop a material which could be used for processing for ourselves and also capitalizing on the benefit this land has, low energy costs, cheap, inexpensive labor, storage conditions, so many other things, where the cost of production as a whole box of it, is much less than Europe. And this will continue to happen. And in order to develop such kind of material which will be fit for processing, I think the modern tools and technologies, innovative ways of doing it, this will be required. And biotechnology, particularly this area in which you have been given the training, is so crucial and so important. And I must congratulate the Division of Education, ICR also, that this topic was selected and this seat of education was given this kind of training. And you are here. And once you go back home, talk to your friends, and during this, tell how important this training is, how good this institution is. And when you go back, I think you might have taken the feedback in writing as well. So based on their suggestions, if you feel some important points are there which can be imbued in the whole process, I think they can also be interlinked and improved upon. And when you conduct this kind of training and become a part of it, I think you learn a lot of things. Once you're going to begin your career in the field of science and technology, you learn how to work in a team manner, how to take a decision in a team manner, how do you coordinate your activities, how do you start respecting the ideas of your colleagues when you are conducting the gel electrophoresis or anything else, gene sequencing, data, analyzing the data Dr. Behra was telling. These are the frontier area. And when the huge amount of genomic resources are available, this has to be put into a background which is really a potential background where the recovery or outcome, recovery in form of outcome or output, is great when we are going to use these natural resources. And the product which is coming out, it should be of a kind which is acceptable to the society, which is safe to the environment and also for the human beings. And I think unless we deploy the high level of skilled people in doing these things, it will be difficult. But I'm happy that 27 people at least in one batch is trained here in this particular area. And once you finish your degree, you will come up with at least certain degree of confidence, competitiveness, that you'll be able to take your decisions, because in the whole process of this training, you might have come across with people, scientists, those who have the diverse areas of expertise. Somebody might be working on physiology, somebody might plant pathology, virology, somebody is working on rice, mango, or so many other crops also. So now we are exposed to such diverse conditions that gives you support in terms of your cognitive abilities to imbibe these things in decision making, to problem understanding, and overall leadership development in you. That is so important. And that is why this kind of training, for you, this might be a training, but behind this whole process of to prepare the whole chartered program for training, I don't know how many meetings might have happened in the ICR with this education division. This invitation is given, so many experts are called, deliberated, discussed, and then this is narrowed down. And then again, how the what process has to be devised in order to draw the best from the available lots. Where to do it, who will be the, he might have thought of many times, who should be the speakers. So you have been given the best which is available with us. You have been given the best to make you best of the best. So that you once you are here for 11 days, 10 days, you would have gone through these kind of experiences and you will understand. And in your life, when you assume a career or start your own startups or become a teacher or become a scientist, either in India or anywhere else, I think these will go as a value. This will be ingrained in your thinking, in your wisdom, and you will remember these things. Like I was remembering our association 35 years back. You are much lucky. Then he has his inclination towards the genes and genetics. So he used to talk, because his brother was a professor of genetics. He had done his PhD from United States. So he used to remember many things from his brother to us. And then it was very enticing, actually. How the DNA looks, how the RNA looks, how to differentiate. It was then only in talks, books, classrooms. You have done it yourself. You have done it yourself. Those equipments, which were the dream that this kind of equipment exists, which carries on the activities like gene sequencing, this is there in United States of America, Japan, Germany, or Europe. This was not here in India. Cost and the trained people. This was marred by these two factors. But now you have access to, you might have accessed these machines and tools. So I think these, you must have enjoyed the time here, academic environment, ICR's, IRI's ecology, IRA evening campus. I'm sure, I'm rather confident, then on many days you must have visited Connaught Place, Karol Bagh, and done a lot of shopping for you and for your family members. And I hope it would have been very fruitful to you. And those who were engaged in this particular training, I must thank you and congratulate you that you have, yet again, you have trained 27 people from different parts of the country, like in the past. But I hope in the future, Director Sahab will get more such kind of trainings or better trainings, not only from ICR, but from other institutions also. I just wanted to share one piece of information. Sometime back, I was in Taiwan for a different purpose, but I visited Academia Sinica, that is in Taipei. So I was taken to a laboratory where the vegetable breeding and persimmon breeding was going on. And then I said, how many scientists are working here? He said, roughly 200. It's a big number for us. So I said, what is the largest position here? He said, the director general. Then I said, can I meet him? He said, yes, it's very easy to meet him. Without appointment, I went to his office, and the professor who took me to his office, he goes into the DG's room, and he says that the one scientist from India has come. He came out. We shook head also. And he said, take him to the Nobel laureates. 200 scientists. And I had a chance to meet 3 Nobel laureates who sit there on a continuous basis. And in an institution where the total strength of the faculty is 200. Then he asked, how many papers you publish in Nature every year? Oh, sir, more than 3 dozens in a year. 3 dozens in a year. Then I said, if you want to send some students from India, will you take? He said, sir, we're looking for Indian students. They're very brilliant. If you visit Academica Sinica, I think there is plenty of a scholarship. I was looking for one opportunity for my daughter. She got full scholarship. How much, you know? $3,600 per month. But Taipei is very expensive. It's good enough. They don't get the students because of the language barrier. But those who might be having interest, you visit the site, go there, it will be outstanding to be there and get yourself trained, and then you can come back here. With this, I must thank the director, very able director of this institution, for giving me this chance to come over here, interact with you. And you, along with our precious colleagues with whom I have maintained our relationship, my personal as well as professional relationship, for such a long time. And I wish you good luck, and be careful for coronavirus. And when you go home, don't take corona with you. Thank you so much, and wish you good luck, and thank you so much.
So he has, you know, the chief guest has spoken about so many touching moments, and I am kind of emotionally reminded of many of such, you know, times. So the one thing I envied about him from beginning was that he was very good at English. His English grammar, his spoken English was very good, and that was my major weakness. Because I came from, you know, of course, he also came from Hindi medium, but I had not studied English as a subject in 9th and 10th, which he had done.
No?
No? Okay. So, so our all...
I have visited your village and you have visited my
village. I was coming to that. I was coming to that. So that was a very strong point in him. His communication was excellent, and his handwriting was very good. My handwriting was very bad. Later on I improved, but it was very bad. But then, you know, he said about, you know, we two walking about 1.5 kilometers one way and returning from hostel to farm, research farm, where agronomy practicals will be conducted. So that will be 3 kilometers of walk. And both of us came from good families, but it is not that, you know, we were walking by choice. Even the cycle, having cycle was a luxury, and we didn't have that. We couldn't afford that. The family could not afford that. So we walked for 3 years to and fro to farm areas, 3 kilometers daily, and studied under all those kinds of constraints, which is not the case with the generation now. Okay, we are planning to take a decision, maybe from next academic session, that IRI will be a green campus, and we will have no vehicle movement on the campus. Everybody has to go on bike. Okay, no scooter, no motorcycle. Even when we were in IRI together, from Sisir Hostel to ISRI on cycle, and from ISRI to Agronomy Division on cycle. So we always cycled, and there was no motorcycle with anybody. So this is something that we need to do. And I felt like, you know, in these hardship, you excel. So the one thing it did, it kept your health very good, because if you walk 3-4 kilometers, you know, and there is no choice for that, you have to do it. It kept you very healthy. It kept you healthy, and it also allowed you to eat more. So we could eat at that point of time maybe 8, 9, 10 chapatis. Today we are on 1 chapati. And many of you, I mean, not more than 3 or 4. So that's the reason, because the physical exercise is not there. So we have to get back to, you know, the original state. That's very important. So, and other thing that was, you know, again, admiration for me from Dr. A.K. Singh, that I was kind of close to outside world, more focused, you know, on studies. But he had his vision open, quite open. And even, for example, reading newspaper, he was very regular, getting English newspaper daily. I never read English newspaper. So those things, and then, you know, his exposure made it different. Coming to IRI was a, you know, altogether different platform, which later provided opportunity for many others to come here and to excel. And coming to IRI was a dream. Even many of us did not know that there is something like IRI that exist. Very few had come, you know, before him, probably 2-3 people. Shekhar Oja and Lavanya, these were the two people, maybe only two. And but when he came, after that, there was a kind of, you know, a lot of people came. So why I said this and why he said this is that there is a lot that we can do. The whole world is open for you. This training program is, as I said, just like a camphor. When you burn the flame, the camphor takes the fire first, and that allows the flame to continue. And the teachers and trainers here are like camphor. They have given the best they had to you in a limited period of time. And now it is for you, how much strength, how much oil you have in you will decide how far you will go. So try to work hard and look forward. There is no end, there is no limit to the extent to which you can progress. Each one of you are like any one of us here, right? And you are best of the best, that's why you are here. So all the best and congratulations for all the future endeavors that you have in mind. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for your inspirational and encouraging words. It's time to acknowledge those who worked behind the curtain. I now request Dr. A.K. Goswami, Scientist Division of Fruits and Horticulture Technology and Course Coordinator, to present the formal vote of thanks.
Thank you, Dr. Yadav. I will start my vote of thanks with a slok in Rig Veda. Vidvattam cha nipattam cha neo tullam kadachana. Swadeshe pujyate raja vidwan sarvatya pujyate. Scholarship and kingship can never be equal to each other. A king is honored only in his own country, while a scholar is honored everywhere. So while people on the dais, such an eminent scholar on the dais, it is indeed a great privilege to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. Sir, on behalf of NAHEP team, on behalf of course director, on behalf of coordinators, and on behalf of the faculty sitting of the dais, it is indeed such a great pleasure to heartfelt gratitude to honorable chief guest of today's valedictorization, our head of the whole horticulture family, Dr. A.K. Singh, sir. Sir, we are really thankful to you that you accept our invitations and you give your precious time to all of us. And you also share your views with the students, which surely will give them a good source of inspiration throughout their life. Sir, I also thankful to our beloved director, sir, Dr. A.K. Singh, sir, who is always available as and when we want any kind of support, any kind of advice, despite his neck-to-neck busy schedule, sir. Really, we are thankful, sir. You are available in inauguration. You are available in valedictory, sir. I am also extremely thankful to our Dean Madam. She is really always gives us constant guidance and support in each and every step in organizing this training program. Ma'am, we are really thankful to you. I'm also extremely thankful to PI of NAHEP, whole NAHEP program, Dr. Vishwanathan sir, who is also head physiology and coordinator school of basic science, for his unwavering support in each and every step in organizing this training program. Sir, although Behra sir is our course director, but he is the person by which we are able to conclude this training program in such a nice way. He planned each and every lecture in a very meticulous way. He always discussed about the resource persons also, always up to 10:30, 11 o'clock. I can show you my phone. At 11:30, he sent some kind of message. Tomorrow we have some schedule change, and please be ready with this. Sir, we are really thankful to you. It's really a pleasure to be with you during this 11 days. I'm also thankful to one of our course coordinator, Dr. Gograj Singh Jat. Day and night, untiring support for this training program, step by step, each and every step, he is there, his input is there. Thank you, Dr. Gograj. And this training wouldn't be successful if I won't thank all the trainees who came, turned in such a great number and representing 16 states of our country. One trainees tell the diversity. So we are working on biofortification as well as diversification. So our trainees is always really enthusiastically to attend class up to 7:30, 8 p.m. and then they are ready to take, today I have taken his class and their class at 8 a.m. in the morning, sir, because we don't have time. So they are always available. I am really thankful to all of you also. Our administrative staff, technical staff, transport staff of IRI, student, SRF, RA, YPs, and supporting staff, I am really thankful to one and all. But this training again won't be possible if the support of entire horticulture fraternity, the school coordinators, head of the divisions, Tomar sir, Sanjay sir, Sindhu sir, head of the divisions of pathology, breeding, and the entire guest faculty. We have published a manual also. Without support of these people, it is not possible. So I am thankful to all of you, sir. And I also thankful to the our education division ICR for providing financial support for this kind of projects. And one and all, I am thankful to all of you. If kindly forgive me if I forget to say thanks. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I request everyone present to please join us in having a cup of tea. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Sir, I'll take it.